Your favourite?
The first High School Musical 1 and 2 are turning into the most successful TV movies in TV history. They're a kind of pop cocktail, like a dash of the Monkees, a splash of S Club 7, a few drops of Grease, and just a hint, not too much of Dirty Dancing or Flashdance. Millions of kids around the world know every single word of every single song by heart. Okay, meet the stars, Zac Efron and Vanessa Hudgens.
Hudgens.
Okay, who play leads Troy and Gabriella, and Lucas Grabeel. That do?
Is yes.
That okay?
Grabeel.
Okay.
But it's all Grabeel.
Americans have such
Grabeel.
Weird names.
Yes.
Well, he means because your ethnicity or whatever is so wide.
And they come from different places, Judy,
yeah,
as well.
That's what I meant to say.
And the jealous stage rival, Ryan, and the lovely Monique Coleman, Gabriella's best friend, Taylor. Yeah?
Yes.
OK, because it is complicated, but if it wasn't complicated, it wouldn't be life, as an old friend of mine used to say. So, basically, your faces are on every bus stop in America, aren't they? I mean, this is massive. This isn't just a little TV gig. It's a really huge thing after the success of the first one. Who wants to answer that? You.
Okay, I said. It kind of turned into that, you know, believe it or not. We're still pinching ourselves, you know, continually. It's,
And each other.
Yeah, yeah. It started off
constantly.
So small.
Can I pinch Judy? Would that be a good idea?
Yeah.
My poster is not on every bus stop in America, Richard. I'm sorry. The debut of High School Musical 2 on the Disney Channel in America got 17.25 million.
Yeah.
It did.
17 and a quarter. We haven't seen ratings in this country like that since what? The heyday of Morecambe
and Wise.
Since Morecambe and Wise.
No, that's true. Yeah, it's huge.
And I think it's probably because those kind of musicals for kids, for sort of kids in their mid-teens and things, they're just not making them anymore, are they?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
If they're making them, they're remaking something that's already been done.
Right. Yeah.
And one of the greatest things about High School Musical is all the songs are original songs.
Yeah.
All the dancing is original choreography.
Right.
We're doing something completely
new. It's fresh. What is the key, do you think? I mean, every generation has their kids' film, don't they? You know, Grease, Flashdance, Dirty Dancing, perhaps for slightly
from
an older.
Story. West Side Story.
One of you wants to be Natalie. Is it you?
You do.
You'd love to be Maria, that's right, in
West
Side Story.
Yeah, I grew up watching, like, Natalie Wood, and
she was beautiful,
that was one of my favourites. Yes, she
you
was.
You look a little bit like her, actually. You've got the same kind of dark colouring, you know?
Thank you.
Anyway, every generation has its movie. All the kids of that generation, in that class of, they know the words, they know the moves, they know the dialogue in between the songs, right? What is it, you think, that makes those films have that special magic that lasts?
I don't know. I think there's something different about those movies. You know, they stick out, and like I said, one of the greatest
things—they're
fresh. You know, the thing that's so crazy about High School Musical is amidst all of this, you know, negativity and sex and drugs on television, especially, you know, even, you know, the message of Grease isn't really that great of a message.
I couldn't agree with you more.
I know.
But
yeah.
this is something
when I saw that
any
for the first time.
Any parent can put their child in front of this movie and not have any worries about what they may think from
it. I like about, again, about in America, at American high schools, is they all embrace this kind of thing. I mean, you've only got to go to Disneyland or Disney World or whatever, and you watch the parades, and before the parades, you see all the local high school kids, the bands, the dancers, the lot, and in their mid-teens, and really, really having a great time, whereas in this country, they tend to slouch about and think, oh,
don't knock our country,
cool do
don't knock our fine youth.
They do. Yeah. They do.
Well, we actually did a signing today, and those were about the nicest kids we've ever
signed for. Oh, I'm not saying they're not nice. I've got
them. Judy's dug a hole for herself. Usually it's me with a shovel slowly going down,
but
there we are.
Yeah, no, they're lovely kids, but what I mean is they would not perform like the way
you have what the Americans call chutzpah, don't you, Monique?
Say it again?
Chutzpah.
Chutzpah. Yes, I, you know, we call it magic. I mean, that's really what it is. I think that it's about chemistry and connecting with one another and being willing to put ourselves out there and be passionate about it and not find it cheesy. And I think that because you've got, you know, a bunch of cool kids that are coming together that are very diverse from diverse backgrounds and ages, it feels like kids can watch this and see someone in it that
they can identify
them.
With, yeah. Yeah. Well, talking of coming together, he said, segueing on to the next clip, we have Zach and Vanessa getting together outside the lockers in the high school, and there's a really touching little ceremony that you perform here. And I'd just like to ask you when we've seen it, what the heck's going on? Because we don't have this in this country. Let's have a look.
Your summer activities consultant has arrived.
Hopefully some of those activities will include a job.
Hey, whatever happens, as long as we're together, it's cool, right?
You promise?
Here's my promise.
He's in Troy.
Why? Yeah. Hey, man, how's it going? There you go, boss.
Oops. Let's go.
Yeah, sure. I'm not busy or anything.
Let's go.
Vanessa, just looking at you, you're not. You're not wearing it.
You're
not wearing the tie.
You
took it off. You swore.
Tell
us about that high school thing in America. Is this the thing when you're breaking for summer that you kind of give each other a token to show that you'll stay steady and true and all that? Is that what it's about?
Oh, yeah.
I guess it's a symbol of it. I mean, it's not like
you
a
mean
ceremony
you didn't stay faithful and true. Sorry, go on. Sorry, go
no,
on.
It is. It's just you know, a little token, and yeah.
We do that. We have like BFF, you know, yeah. Like bracelets,
and best friend,
best friends,
friends
forever.
Best friends forever. Best friends forever.
But they've been doing that since the 50s. I mean, making yeah. You know, giving yeah. Them your class ring, your letter jacket.
Your jacket
you know.
We just exchange blood, you know.
That's
real.
No, because you were born in yeah. Springfield, Missouri.
Yeah.
Is that where the Simpsons movie premiered?
Well, I wish it was. Springfield is actually the most common city name in the United States.
Right.
So
right.
There's tons of them. But we, you know, they tried to, everyone that was a Springfield sent in a video to get the, you know,
the
people
premiere.
To bring it the premiere there. But unfortunately, we didn't make it.
You didn't make it. It was another spot.
Although there is one episode where they have all the snakes and they beat them, and that actually happened in Springfield, Missouri.
No.
Really?
In, like, 1896, yeah.
Next time I see that, I shall bear that in mind. Listen, you're kind of, you and your twin sister in the film, you're kind of the villains.
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you build up yourself.
Because you normally get the best, you normally get the lead roles
right,
in the musical.
Right.
But actually, these two are now sort of breaking out of their boxes.
Because you're really bright and you're really sporty. And there's this kind of clash going on between the sort of the arty types, the academic types, the sporty types. And what? Just explain the baseball scene. We'll have a quick look at the baseball scene. Great scene. What's all that about?
Well, that's the big musical.
The baseball scene basically takes place with me and Chad, who Chad is best friends of Troy, and he is a total sports fan, doesn't believe in dancing or theater or music and all that stuff. And I basically tell him that, you know, to play baseball, you got to be able to dance.
Yeah.
To be able to dance. You can, if you know how to play baseball, then you can totally.
Well, let's close this with that. It's just a bit of what looks like a great scene set piece. Let's have a look.
Cool. I don't dance. I know you can. Not a chance. No. If I can do this, well, you can do that. But I don't dance.
Get it out of the way.
I don't dance.
I say you can.
It's not a chance.
Oh no.
Slide on the dance floor, swinging on the dance floor. I don't dance. No.
Get back, tuck it in, take a chance. Spin around, do the dance.
I wanna play ball, not dance hall. I'm making a triple, not a curtain call.
I can prove it to you till you know it's true. Cause I can swing it, I can bring it to the diamond too.
You're talking a lot, show me what you got. Stop, swing.
It looks great, guys, and a really joyous movie and great for kids everywhere. And thank you very much. It's been a joy to talk to you all today.
Nice
meeting you.
High School Musical 2 premieres in Britain at the O2 Arena in London's Docklands this Sunday, and then it debuts on the Disney Channel here on Friday, 21st.